was just heading out the door, the booster pack, and I'm gonna see if I can get my little four-wheeler around there. Old 70 that's having an old little Geo 70 down there. Haven't ran about 2 years, I think. Yeah, about two falls ago. It hasn't ran since then, so. Boost pack in my hand, let's see down there if we can get this thing around. I put some fuel on the other day and then I had to leave, so I didn't really get a chance to get the thing going. So it's been sitting down here for a while. But I just, it was in way down there in the woods. It was like in behind the lawn tractor on the other side there. It was like in that hole, so. I figured I'd put some fuel on it. And a bunch of fuel probably, or water might have went in there. But fuel in the fuel filter, not really much of it, but to make sure there's still some fuel in the tank. Yep, it should be enough to start. If not, I'll go get some more, but that's all right. This thing needs to be sold, it really does. So if I get it running today, it's being sold. But if it's not being, if it's not running by this video's time's over, I'll be keeping it and doing work to it and getting it to run before I sell it. Because I want the thing to run. Because it's worth a bit more if you have it running before it. Well, I mean, I know the motor will run. It was a good running motor, but then my brother was 17 at the time, or 16, I think. And he got on it and started wheeling it and stuff. He broke the front sprocket in half and the chain, so, and we never found the parts for it, so it ended up down here. That's not what I was looking for, is it? Battery pack's fully charged on. Still nothing, huh? The cables. The ignition is up, I think. It's gotta be. No, I guess not. Any lights? They were burnt out anyway, so that wouldn't help us. Huh. That's not good. And there's a hole in my fuel filter. That ain't good either. Shut fuel off. Hurry up, please. Come on, just whirl. Do something. I don't know, maybe the green one's power, which doesn't make any sense, but we'll try it. Oh. That's it, it made spark. Starter might be junked. Or maybe this thing won't run on direct power. Maybe it needs to have a battery hooked to it. Like a actual battery. Cause it ain't doing anything, I mean, like, anything, like, it's not even making turnover. Hook you in there, and put these here, like this, so hopefully we get a good connection. Come on, whirl! Everything's on properly, I mean, that's there, it's on, but nothing. And this is the ignition, so. Nothing. That's not good. Well, maybe I'll hook up a battery to it and see if we can do it that way. Booster cables off, booster pack off. Or see if I can just get this battery out, but it hasn't been any good in a few years. Set you guys there for a second so I can pull this stupid freaking battery out. No. Just a little thing there. To be honest, I might just go up there and fire up the big four wheeler. Right down there. See if it will fire. It should. I just got a new key made for it. Hasn't ran in, well, since last fall when we put it away. So, we'll get that one going. It has. We just got a new key made because we lost the key and put a battery in it and stuff, but never. We whirled it a few times. We had no gas in it, so we just said screw it. But then I got some gas and put it in, so. See if I can get her going. I just force her rubber snipper. And I lost my booster cables on the ground. 400 Suzuki. There's a battery in it, but it's just, I don't think it's got enough life in it to go. I think that's what Dad said. So the key is now on, but all it does is, which means this battery is not charged enough to make it, well, start, basically. I don't know, Dad might have had this running, but as soon as I started, he'll be able to tell if it's been running. But Dad, I think, might have had it going, so. But, we'll still get it going. So why not? So choke is down. Yeah, Dad had it going. Joke, it just dies. three cans of seafoam, I would say. Holy. This thing needs a good 20-30 minute drive before that battery's charged. Battery's been dead for a while. Well, we can try up the lawn tractor too. It's been sitting down there underneath the green tarp there. That's what that was. Just sitting under there with it. I know that battery's good because it never goes dead. So I'm not even concerned about using the booster pack, so I'm just gonna throw it in this. And this time, that thing obviously has been running. Dad had it running because it fired right up. But this thing, I swear, it has not been running. It's still buried. Two little sleds in there, like Polaris. That's an RMK. Oh, I guess I kind of lost about 4%, so. Had a full thing of gas when it's put away. Choke it, make sure it's got battery. Month or two before we can even use it, probably. Everything's still a massive mud hole around here. This is the old Yamaha 1000 four stroke car. Dual exhaust out the rear. Runs really good. Should start then. Choke. Battery's dead. I ain't screwing with that then. Battery dead, I don't want any part of it. Nope. Battery's dead, I don't want any part of it. I don't want to completely drain it because those batteries will come back up to charge. So. So yeah, we got a fire cat, a few sleds in here. Fire up one of the triples. This thing should have still a decent battery in it. Fuel pump run. This runs, and there, of course, is a race sled. This thing is fast as heck. This thing is retarded fast, and it sounds amazing. It doesn't really sound that great at idle, but trust me, you get this thing down the field, and you pin it. Oh, it sounds like one of those new 850s. Guys, I'll fire this up. I'm just gonna move this old Polaris cab later. Oh, this is the. I made a video about this sled. This cab came off of actually. It was called a new sled, I believe. That was a few days ago. Well, a few months ago, probably now. Choke it. I ain't gonna be able to pull this thing through all the clay, but it's fresh actually. Set you guys right here on this thing. So plain, it's just sitting on a piece of metal, so it just kind of spins a bit. It's just sitting on a big piece of metal, so it's kind of just frozen in the ground still a little bit. I mean, well, the skis are just planted into the ground, so it's got massive carbides on it. The thing won't even barely move with the grass, anyway. I think Dad's got a ZR900, but I think it's or ZR800 in the garage, but it's stripped, I think, now. I hate this freaking thing every time I walk on a piece of plywood. No, Dad, get the snowblower in here, though. Or both the snowblowers. Snowblowers and all the parts. This thing's cool. A bunch of bits. Then you just press the button and twist it. So. That's cool. Massive new toolbox here. Tools and parts. And a bunch of other stuff. Two snow blowers. Two for a while. It's pretty well full, too. So yeah, but that's pretty much what's left in the yard now. This is a 750 turbo. Doesn't run. I think it's blown up actually. Yeah. Ooh, maybe this lawn boy mower is out of the snow. This thing is destroyed, but it does run. So I will start this thing actually. This thing have a choke on it? Or a primer? Doesn't have a choke or a primer. Okay. I guess we're gonna be doing a lot of pulling. But this thing don't have a primer. Or anything to start with. Well, you need a primer too. My lawnmower has been sitting for the whole winter. I was really hoping that quad was gonna do what it was supposed to, but I guess it didn't. Get a battery put in it or whatever. But yeah, that's today's video. See you guys later.